a secret.
Welcome back. SportsCast live in the Juicewood Studios. Again, make sure you check us on iTunes. Download the show, subscribe, leave a review. Our SoundCloud channel, YouTube. Just basically type in SportsCast, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter. You guys will find us. We don't have the phones up today. You guys can blame Knocker again. Didn't pay the bill. We'll have it up probably next week if I find the time to do it.
Well, if you deposit some money in the account, I would pay the bill.
I did actually deposit some money in the account.
Obviously not, because you called me saying we're overdrawn. Have you had a finger up your ass? That'll break the tension.
Yeah, I was about to say, that's a good tension breaker right there. All right, Knock. Let's travel the world of sports and cover the headlines from around the world. I can't even finish. Here we go.
It's been a problem for you for a while.
Spanning the globe to bring you the constant variety of sports.
All right, Knock. I'm going to throw you some questions around the horn here, guys. Give me your 30-second input and let you know how you feel. Throw me out some background here, Renee, and get the pictures ready if you can. LeBron James, Kyrie Irving, Kevin Love will not travel with Cleveland for tonight's game against the Memphis Grizzlies. Knocker, is this greatly devaluing the amount of the ticket, right? Do you think this is right? And do fans deserve to see these players play?
No. This is business. The Cavaliers are in the business of winning basketball games. Not just winning basketball games, winning championships.
But I got a ticket, Knocker. Okay. It's the only game I go to all season long.
Why is it?
My team's not good, and I want to see LeBron.
Then go to Cleveland.
But I live halfway across the country, and I saved all year to watch
this
game.
You
and
live
they're
in
not
going
to have three superstars aren't going to play. What are you going to do about
Get
that?
Get over it. You live in Memphis.
Were you born between 1985 and 2000? Because you sound like a millennial.
It's okay.
That's what the people are watching.
It's
that's
okay
what they're complaining
it's
right
okay
now.
If Popovich does it. It's okay if a team shows up, but then they tank. I mean, what the hell is the difference, man?
Cam, you're a basketball guy, man. What do you think, man?
I think, actually, what I heard a great idea is they should give refunds or discounts to the people that are buying tickets. But I agree. Like, the Cavaliers, they're in the business of winning championships. Don't screw with their strategy. But here's what you should do. You should shorten the regular season so that they're not doing that.
Or eliminate space the games out.
Eliminate back-to-backs, exactly. Like the NFL. Make it safer for the players.
There you go.
I'm with you guys, too, man. If they need to take off a day or two to make sure that they're in the playoff. The Cavs are already going to win the East. It's not like they need these games.
Okay,
and you know,
cut out five preseasons.
LeBron's played enough. Save the knees,
right,
man.
Cut out five preseason games and make the regular season 70 games.
Get the video ready for me here, Renee. Now, again, stick with LeBron and Kyrie. Now, they're doing so well, the Cavs, right now. In a game earlier over the Knicks, they had a blowout win over the Knicks. And it was so boring.
Who hasn't?
It was so boring, Knocker. That LeBron James decided to play that, where you flip the bottle, water bottle challenge?
Right.
They did it during the live game on the sidelines. Throw out the video. You have the video of the one where he's throwing the bottle? LeBron James playing the flip drink game here? Yeah, there it is. Here, look at Knocker. This is during the game. He's playing it on the court. They're just having fun. Now, is that disrespectful? Would any other superstar do that? Would Magic do it in the day? Is this something you agree with? What are your thoughts?
That happened in the 80s, man. Somebody would definitely have just taken a
Bill Laimbeer just, you know,
and taken a 90 degree right into that calf bench. It was a loose ball and just run him right
do
over as he sits. Yes, totally disrespectful.
That bothers you. What you just saw right now bothers
total,
you.
Total disrespect for the other
so
team.
Funny.
Cam?
Phil Jackson's been disrespectful to the Knicks organization putting that product on the court. I don't care about him flipping a water bottle. Get a better damn team. They suck.
There you go.
They're
all right.
Awful.
I think with like my generation now and like the times, like that's just how you shit talk.
Yeah.
Like that's just how you shit talk, and it's like, give me one better. Play better than me.
Yeah.
I mean,
I'm beating you by 30.
You're literally,
what else do you want me to do?
You're literally and utterly boring the shit out of me.
Yeah, it's crazy. Now, sticking here, lastly in the NBA, man, Chauncey Billups, he's going to be a Hall of Famer, said that some of his teammates smoked before games and performed better when they were high, Knocker.
Absolutely.
Now,
totally
I'm going to say that's true because I smoke a lot of pot and I perform way higher, literally, when I'm smoking pot. My performance
smoke weed every day.
I truly believe that. That no problem with
now,
that.
Now, do you
all.
Think players? Do you think more players do this than people think? Do you think there's more players than they get high?
God, especially with edibles. Now that there's no smell, you can just drop a chocolate.
But then you gotta go out and hit three pointers,
dude. That's what they do for a living, bro. That's what they do for a living. Look at you in a golf course.
Yeah, right? But I've seen you take a chocolate bar, and if I gave you a chocolate bar now, you would not be able to perform.
No, but see, I grew up on just weed. You're doing drugs.
It's so totally, true.
Totally different
dude,
thing.
I'm at a...
Okay?
Yeah.
Seriously, this is not the weed your daddy grew up with.
Keep it going.
Okay?
Keep the music going.
No, seriously. I think they... Absolutely they do, because they hurt. They're in pain. I'd rather a guy... No, seriously. I'd rather the guy chew the edible... Right?
Yeah, then
and
pop
go
a
out,
fucking Vicodin.
Then take a needle.
Yeah,
take a pharmaceutical. Absolutely.
Dude,
no problem.
We're at NXL Florida, the World Cup of paintball. And yeah, people think whatever. You guys have to like go into bunkers and shoot your paintball gun and like literally be aware, right? Like your eyes are open. These fools, just three of them, just hit a bong rack. We're going in the semifinals. Like,
yeah.
What the
Yeah.
They're like, oh, we play better.
It's so prevalent. Okay. It is. It's really so prevalent that your generation can function on stuff.
I don't get it.
You
like,
look
I do
at me
not
like
get it.
You don't even know how I function on database.
I have no idea how you and Renee do this show. I have absolutely no idea how you are just...
And I'm an accountant. Like, all I do is work with numbers.
Exactly. But see, you're used to that. These guys growing up, that's what they do.
Yeah.
And I'd much rather have them do that than take greenies or take steroids or anything else that's not natural. This is natural. Man, yep. Go for it, bro.
All right, next up
Plus,
here.
Plus, halftimes are so much better when you're high.
I know.
Oh, my
Laker
God.
Girls,
that
right?
15 minutes flew.
That Asian chick spinning all those plates looks a lot cooler when you're stoned.
Wait. That monkey jumped through the ring on the bike? That's crazy. Oh,
that mascot going through that fire ring is awesome.
Have you guys ever watch this halftime show? This guy stacks chairs.
Look at that gorilla, man. That guy's cool.
Can you believe these guys keep the beat on these buckets? Unbelievable.
Blue Man Group's got nothing on these guys.
They're all just right. homeless no. with trash cans.
Absolutely, they do it. I don't have a problem.
All right, next up here, Knocker. Floyd Mayweather vows to slap the shit out of punk-ass Conor McGregor when he sees him.
I want to see
it. Do you care anymore? Do you care about this fight? Do you think it's ever going to happen? And our boy, Oscar De La Hoya, said he wants Conor McGregor to fight Canelo Alvarez. I think if Canelo fights, Canelo's going to beat the shit out of him.
Canelo, kill him.
He would kill him.
But I could care less about Mayweather and McGregor. But
Mayweather would slap the shit out of McGregor, I think.
If they happen to meet each
in a
other,
boxing
I
match?
So want to be there.
Yeah,
no,
so do
just
I.
on the street.
Yeah, just... Yeah.
Cruising down Vegas. Just entourage, full-out brawl.
Dude.
Love it.
Yeah, I would love it, too.
Love it.
Be fantastic. All right, Knocker, getting over to baseball. Yankees agreed to a ridiculous $5 million, a five-year, $86 million contract with closer Aroldis Chapman, who we know won the World Series with Chicago, but was previously with the Yankees before that. Now goes back with the Yankees. Good or bad signing?
Well, you know me. I'm not a long contract guy. 3 years for a closer.
For a guy that pitches maybe three innings a week and you get him for three games, you're going to pay him that much money?
Well, I didn't say he wasn't worth the money.
I'm saying he's not worth
the money. He's not. No, he's worth
the money. He's
not. No, he's worth the money. He's not worth the years. He's worth the money for 3 years. Whatever it contracts out to for 3 years, just like goalies in hockey. Look at the statistics on how long a closer lasts. Look at it. They peak for three, maybe 4 years. He's already had two. He's only good for another couple of years. If something is going to happen, you are not going to get a return on that investment the last 2.5 to 3 years of that contract. It's insanity.
I know you cannot
have collusion. I know collusion is illegal, but these owners have to stop this insanity of paying that much money when you know they're not going to get the payoff on the last 2 to 3 years. It's just not going to happen.
Right?
You
look at the Dodgers basically throwing the
same
amount
thing.
Of money,
Jansen's
$80 million,
5 years
for Kenley Jansen here.
He will
with
be
the
gone.
Dodgers.
He will not be in a Dodger uniform in 3 years. Guarantee
just,
you.
I don't get the money for a guy that it's not even in your starting lineup every day. I don't understand
it.
There's not a guy in the bullpen that can get three outs for $5 million a year.
He's automatic outs.
Obviously not.
Is he?
Yeah.
Obviously not.
Because was he in the playoffs?
He had his down games, but for the most part.
His down games, you only get five of them in the playoffs. How many down games can you have?
It's 95%. And again, it's not just the closer anymore. This stuff starts in the seventh inning now.
Yeah, I know. It's crazy.
Seven,
ridiculous.
Eight, nine, even six, seven,
the
eight, nine.
The bullpen's almost more important than the starting rotation.
Absolutely. And that's why you cannot spend that much money on one guy. You move your number eight guy to the ninth, and you rotate guys to the bottom. I would never, as an owner, give a guy like that many years.
Renee,
it's just like a goalie in hockey.
You know, I think 4 years would have been enough. Five, I think, you know, he's still in his 20s. So, you know, he's all they got right now. I mean, there's not a lot of closers out there in the market. And to be honest with you, I'd rather have Jansen than I would Chapman. That's just me, though. I think he's mentally more stable than Chapman. Because he wasn't – you know what? His arm is still fresh. He was a catcher before he became a pitcher. So he hasn't been pitching that long, really. So
you're a guy that values closers?
Yeah, I mean, if they're good, that's what makes you win games.
Not a crappy bullpen.
I don't know. I think that you could go a closer by committee almost. I mean,
but dude, look at the Indians, okay? Look at the Indians this year, and look at the Royals the year before. Not the greatest hitting teams, not the greatest offensive teams.
But they had Joaquin Soria at their bullpen,
pitcher went 5 2/3, it was game over. It was game over. When it got to the pen with a 2-run lead, you were dead in the water.
Yeah.
And that's the way the game is played
that's
now.
That's how the Indians, yeah.
The thing I like about the Jansen signing is, I don't know if you guys know, but he got married over the weekend. And I think a lot of his decision was swayed upon. He was around his teammates. He was around people that he loved. He wanted to stay in L.A. for the family. And he turned down more money from the Marlins to stay with the Dodgers because of those factors in place.
Yeah,
so
and
I think
and it's
basically
the
loyalty. He chose loyalty over the money.
I think context matters in these two signings because the Chapman signing, the Yankees got something for Chapman.
Yeah.
So the return on investment is you got two prospects. Now with Jansen, you just almost signed over more of your money.
You mean
and
the
you're
Cubs
giving,
got two prospects?
No, the Yankees got two prospects from the Cubs for that half-season rental.
Oh, okay. And then they signed him back.
Yeah, and then they signed him back. So it's almost like they did collude in a sense to get him back, but you already have something that you got for him because you traded for the half-season
now,
rental.
Did the Yankees also sign Andrew Miller? Did I see that they signed Miller from the Indians? I'm not sure.
I don't think.
But they already have, they already have in their bullpen, they had Miller, Betance, and...
Oh, that's the Miller I'm talking about.
Yeah, they had Andrew Miller, they had Betance, and Chapman last year, and they traded away Miller and Chapman.
Right.
So you still have two of those dynamite guys.
Right.
So we'll
that's
see what
the game's played now, Josh. It makes me, you know, the
I don't
old,
like
the
it,
olden
man.
Days where you got the ball and you pitched 8 2/3.
Yeah, now it's like two times through the lineup. You know,
a quality start is 5 innings.
What do you think of that?
What do you guys
think about that whole ban of that? They can't dress up like women anymore for being hazed. The rookies can't be hazed. They can dress up like superheroes, but dressing up like a woman is offensive. You can't dress up like a Hooters waitress because that's gonna offend somebody.
I'm not a hazing culture guy. Yeah, I'm not. I'm with Knocker too.
I think hazing is just like.
It's just like, I don't. What do I get out of making a guy feel like shit or embarrassing him?
Now,
I've never been that kind of guy because I don't like bullies. I don't
like
people getting made fun of in public. I've never been a guy that I get satisfaction off watching another guy's misery. I don't understand it, so I don't really. I think, who gives a shit? Like, it's not going to be missed. Who cares?
I don't mind them making him carry the bags or buying donuts on the road or got to pay for breakfast when we go on the road or whatever. But anything past that, I'm just.
Yeah, I'm not
a fan.
Yeah.
I'm really not. Okay, they can't wear dresses, huh?
Yeah.
Right, okay.
All right, B-Knock. Well, let's flip over
Damn
tide
it,
here.
I was so into just this one dress.
Let's flip over the tide here. Let's get into your college football. We got a lot of bowl games coming up. Got a lot of bowl games coming up here in the next few weeks, Knocker. Go over some of these crazy bowl names that we've got going here. But real quick, a couple side notes, Knocker. Lamar Jackson. Going to win your 2016 Heisman Trophy winner. What are your thoughts on that real quick? Well deserved? No, yes. Do you think the Michigan guy should have got it? USC?
He had a good year. He had a great year. Started off really well. The team sort of took a nosedive. It just doesn't mean the same to me as it used to because now you have the Doak Walker Award. You have the Biletnikoff Award. You have the Blackfish Award. You have the... whatever the
team is.
There's an award for every position now. So I think this being stuck with, it's either quarterback or a running back, it's got to go. It really does. I think it has to go to the best football player, right? And we're going to argue Jabril Preppers and Adoree Jackson all year long. But they both run back kicks. They both play defense. They both touch the ball on offense. When either one of those two guys touch the ball on offense, they're a threat to go all the way anytime. They're good defensive players. I think one of those two should have won, or maybe even a defensive player that just brings it and changes the way the game is played. I'm not a big fan of the Heisman anymore. I'm just not. He's a good player. Give him the best quarterback award and be done with it. But give me the best football player in the country.
Lane Kiffin, man. He looks like he's going to be accepting a job at Florida Atlantic. What are your thoughts on that?
I think it's a great move for him. I truly do. I think
good facilities, nice recruiting.
You're the number 4 or 5 dog in the state, right?
Especially with South Florida
turned their program around with Taggart, who is now the coach
of
Oregon, right? You're the last dog, but the state is full of recruits.
It's insane, yeah.
Right? I think he's a great coach for that because his offense will work well in that lesser conference. He did well at Alabama, but I think the Saban-Kiffin thing had reached its peak, right? And it's a stepping stone for him. Although, if I was a player in the South with his past reputation at the University of Tennessee, I'm not sure I would trust this guy to be there 3 years from now. You know what I'm saying? Win or lose. So I think he's going to have a hard time convincing people that he's in it for the long haul. But I think it's a good move for him.
And lastly here, Knocker, just with the before you get to the bowl games, Tommy Elroy, former Wake Forest football player, assistant coach, has served as the team's color man brought in the broadcast studios, now reportedly being an investigation for turning over game plans to their opponents here, Knocker. And Louisville's already come out and said that, yeah, this actually did happen. We had talks with them. Obviously, Tommy Elroy's been let go by the team now, been relieved of his duties, but I don't know. How deep is this going? What are your thoughts on this, man? Because I think there's more to come here, more schools, more information is going to be divulged here in the next 48 hours.
I don't know what his motivation was. I
don't either, because it seems from what the reports are, the guy was loved where he was at.
My problem is with any school that actually talked to him. If I'm this guy and I'm calling the University of Louisville.
Did they get sanctioned?
And say, absolutely they should. Without question. Without question, if you're going to penalize other schools.
Knocker, if you tell me a secret, and I don't ask you to tell me the secret, why is it my fault?
Because I know you work for Wake Forest. As soon as you're on the phone, say, hi, I'm so-and-so, and you're from another school, I hang up the phone. I do not talk to you. I do not spend any time with you at all, especially if I'm a higher echelon program. What does Louisville need Wake Forest game plan for?
Knocker, if you robbed a bank, told me you robbed a bank, and I didn't turn you in, you're going to tell me I'm just as fault as you are?
I wouldn't tell you. Yeah. If I told you,
what?
Hey, Josh,
no.
I robbed a bank. Click. Never heard a thing. Don't even want to talk to you.
But you heard it.
Then I would expect
you. You heard it.
I would expect you to turn me in.
Come on, Knocker.
Nah, raise.
I think you should check your phone.
No, but seriously, this guy's on the other end of the phone, and he's contacting you saying, I want to sell you secrets. It's Wake Forest, man.
Yeah.
Really? And if there's not sanctions against Louisville, right, there's just something wrong. Absolutely.
All right,
let's
get into these bowl games here, Knocker.
Hang on, because Louisville, the first time they talked to this guy, should have reported it to the NCAA. This guy contacted us from Wake Forest. We told him to go pound sand, but this actually happened. Do your thing.
And we got a couple people on Twitter that really, they want to know what our holiday schedule is. We will be back next week on Wednesday. The week after Christmas, since I'll be in Dallas, we'll do a Thursday show on that week. So, all right, Knock, what's going on in the Bulls? Let's wrap this up here.
Well, the Bull season starts December 17th. We got a full slate of games. The Air Force Reserve Celebration Bowl.
Oh, my God. Woo! That's my favorite bowl.
I'm going to have a party.
That's just so great.
I'm going to celebrate the Air Force.
Are we going to get together for that one, guys?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Absolutely.
North Carolina Central and Grambling. Stick to your TV, man. This is going to be a whale of a contest. We have the Gilded New Mexico Bowl.
I like that one. The Gilded New Mexico. I like it. All right. I'll mark that one down.
Okay. This is the one. If I was a college student, this is the one I want to go to. The Las Vegas Bowl.
Yeah.
Presented by Geico.
Free lap dances.
Yeah, free lap dances. It's actually a pretty good game. You got Houston versus San Diego State. San Diego State.
Actually, not a bad
won,
game.
The Mount West Conference this year. It's not a bad football game. The Raycon Media Camellia Bowl.
Oh, my God. I mean, if I'm the team that gets into that game, I am just stoked,
I
man.
Just love the name of the stadium they're playing in, too. It's the Crampton Bowl in Montgomery, Alabama.
Pretty cramped in here.
That's what I call my wife's week once a month, the Crampton Bowl.
Oh my God. Wow. Yeah, but mine was too offensive.
No, right?
Mine was too offensive.
No, you got to call it Shark Week.
There you go.
Appalachian State versus
There's
Toledo.
Blood in the water.
The Auto Nation Cure Bowl. Now, Auto Nation Cure, what is
Wait,
that?
Wait, Auto Nation Cure Bowl?
Auto Nation Cure Bowl. Auto Nation, I can see.
Okay.
Cure, I have no idea. What is Auto Nation curing?
It's like these southern kids that have five different names. I don't understand
it. I don't know, but it's at Camping World Stadium. The R&L Carriers New Orleans Bowl. What is this, like the fourth step down from UPS?
Ridiculous.
Right?
Yeah.
Let's see what turquoise can do for you. Right?
Turquoise, dude.
Then we move to December 19th. This is another one I'd like to go to.
Okay.
The Miami Beach Bowl.
Oh, yeah.
Not a bad deal.
Miami Beach.
And you've got Central Michigan coming from probably -8 degrees in Tulsa, Oklahoma, which is probably right at zero right about now.
Can we stay?
You think those two teams are going exactly? Do we got to go home?
Let's just stay.
There's women here wearing nothing. We got to go back to Tulsa?
Yeah.
Are you kidding?
We're going to transfer out.
Yeah, hooking up there has got to be a crapshoot. They both have coats on. They're like, all right, we'll drop our coats in 3 seconds. One, two, three. Oh!
Well, it'll be a crapshoot in two ways.
Oh!
But a bump. A lot of penicillin. A lot of fine stock and penicillin after that ball.
The VD Bowl.
The STD Bowl, brought to you by
Jersey Shore.
Johnson & Johnson.
Johnson & Johnson.
Every December 20th, we got the Boca Raton Bowl.
I like
December
that one. It 21st. Sounds fancy.
This might have the longest one. The San Diego County Credit Union Poinsettia Bowl.
Oh, my God. Like,
the I can't qualify what for
is
a
the
loan bowl.
What does the jersey patch look like for that? Like, is it just, like, all over the place?
Instead of a number in front, you've got
the
logo.
Yeah, it's like a soccer jersey instead. You know, it's just, like, right there.
You know what it reads? I have bad credit.
Yeah. Yeah. Your number on your back is your credit score. Like, that's what you're playing with.
And if you win, you all get all your credit deduced.
Yeah, right. Yeah,
mine's 525.
Yeah, awesome. Man, that 390 guy, he needs to get his shit together.
Man, that quarterback's having an awesome game. He's got a 710.
Then we go to December 22nd, the most obvious name of the bowl, the famous Idaho Potato Bowl.
I like that one. I can do potatoes.
Then we go to the Popeye's Bahamas Bowl.
The Popeye, so I get Popeye's chicken while I'm in Hawaii?
Or is this spinach or is this fried chicken? Right? Then we got the Lockheed Martin Armed Forces Bowl, so I can understand
the
that.
Lockheed Martin.
Hey, whoa. Martin. Lockheed Martin has made the F-14,
right.
The
they
F-16.
Build, they build jets, so that one actually
he's cool.
Makes
all right,
sense.
Sorry.
They're cool.
Okay.
This one is the Rene Bowl, the Dollar General Bowl.
That would be the Peso Bowl.
Right? Yeah, exactly. It's Ohio versus Troy.
Dollar General Store Bowl.
Brad Pitt
movie. Mine would be
right
the 99
there.
Cent Store Bowl.
Don't mock.
And Hawaii, for all their great work this year,
yeah.
The University of Hawaii gets to travel to Hawaii.
All right.
Yeah. The Hawaii Bowl.
Yeah.
Against Middle Tennessee. Middle Tennessee is going to come into this game so effing drunk and hungover.
Hell yeah.
That is not going to be funny. Okay, we got the Quick Lane Bowl.
We got 30 seconds here now.
Zaxby's Heart of Dallas Bowl. What the hell is Zaxby's Heart of Dallas Bowl?
I think it's turkey.
They should replace it with the cereal bowl.
Is Zaxby's turkey?
You know what it is?
What? No, I don't.
It's the sound effect bowl. It's the Heart of Texas Bowl.
Oh. Okay.
That's what
like
it was.
And here's one for you high-class travelers. The Motel 6 Cactus Bowl.
Yeah.
This is played on a sand field.
They'll leave the light on for you.
Hey. With cones for a marker, and everybody stays in that Motel 6 with a continental breakfast.
Sponsored by Comcast.
Well done.
It's in beautiful Phoenix, Arizona,
there
too.
There you go. All right, Knock. Well, we'll get to the rest of next week because we'll have time, right, to cover the later games.
Absolutely, next week, for sure.
All right, guys. Well, let's get out of here. We ran a little late as usual. Well, I thank Renee on the ones and twos.
Yeah, man.
Thank you. We've got a new intern. Thank you for coming in. Hope you enjoyed the show. All right. Yeah. And... You got Danbury.
I just want to add one point. This shout out to my cousin Dylan. Oregon, you know, they didn't make a bowl and everything, but they.
Aww.
No, I know, but they got 100 jerseys, but zero national championships.
Woo, still working on that first one. But God, they look pretty.
Why do I get you? I don't even want to ask you to be on the show.
I just love talking shit.
Like, you're my brother. I think it's cool to have you on, but sometimes I don't give a fuck.
I think that's because you're 11 in Giants.
All right, we're going to battle it out here on the show.
No more.
Hey, Cam, man, happy to have you back. Glad you got a new car
nice
going
ride.
On, man.
Yeah, nice
new job
day,
paying
baby.
Off.
Yeah.
Glad, man. Good to go. All right, guys, we'll be back next week on Wednesday again, and then after Christmas, we'll be back on that Thursday. So that's our new schedule coming up for the next couple weeks. So, all right, guys, for everyone on the crew here, love you guys all. Same bad channel, same bad place. We'll be back next week. Wait.